Okay, good afternoon or good day. We will about to discuss military as a social institution. Speaking of military, it refers to soldiers, arms, as well as war. That's the definition. Also, a military, also known collectively as armed forces, it is heavily armed and highly organized force primarily intended for warfare. The terms armed forces and military are often treated as synonymous. What is the history of the armed forces of the Philippines? During prehistoric period, there are tribal groups like Aitas, Mangyan, Maranao, and they have military or soldiers. During that time, they develop weapons as well. In the lower right side, there is a comparison between weapons before and now. During pre-colonial period, there are Datu, Sultans, and Moro. The famous Battle of Mactan proves that even pre-colonial period, there are soldiers or military. During Spanish period, Spanish Army and Guardia Civil has been installed. But during American period, Philippine Constabulary has been organized. Yan, 1901. American period also, Armed Forces of the Philippines was officially established on December 21, 1935 in accordance with the National Defense Act of 1935. Yan pala yung pagkakatatag ng AFP 1935. But during Japanese invasion, after Japan was defeated in World War II, the Philippines gained its independence in 1946. Ito yung AFP organization. 1987 Constitution, civilian authority, and commander-in-chief ay ang presidente ng Pilipinas. So the military is civilian controlled. Meron tatlong sangay ang AFP. Yan. Air Force, Army, and Navy. Ang dating branches niyan ay ang PC, Constabulary, naging Integrated National Police, which is currently as the Philippine National Police. This is the leadership during the President Rodrigo Roa Duterte. According to Marcos Garvey, a people without the knowledge of their past history, origin, and culture is like a tree without roots. Ganda nung sinabi niya. What is the importance of military as a social institution? Why we need to study it? To understand its norms and how it shapes an individual and its role and contributions in society. Also to know not only the importance of the army but also the most important conflicts in history that made our society what it is today. Also, civilians' knowledge about the military is limited to what they have acquired from movies, books, and news reports. Few outside the military understand the culture, the values, or the people who make up military force. What do people see in the armed forces that makes them dedicate their lives, even women and their families' lives, to military service? Why we need to study it? For civilians with little or no personal exposure to military culture, the armed forces may seem overwhelming, incomprehensible, esoteric, or even anachronistic. However, to understand, work with it, and help those who serve in the armed forces, it is necessary to have a general understanding of the institution. How have the wars affected today's armed forces and its personnel? The aim of military training is not just to prepare men for battle, but to make them long for it. The past, present, and future are inextricably tied. Common threads throughout the history of humankind that includes both the idealistic pursuit of peace and the reality of war. The inclination toward conflict is part of the human condition, but the opportunity to help prevent wars in the future lies in our understanding of past and current global conflicts. Also, military education is valuable because it provides an intellectual architecture for battlefield success. It contributes also to stable civil-military relations, a culture of reflection, and a capacity for critical analysis. The Army is an extraordinary organization full of a multitude of values and brotherhood, and above all, a lot of generosity. People who would not hesitate for a moment to make their lives available to others if necessary, so that we can enjoy state of well-being and thus maintain our security. Sipin ninyo, may mga taong handang itaya ang kanilang buhay at maging sila ay laging naroon para lang sa kapakanan ng ating seguridad, ng military. Significance in the lives of people. Military is a professional, national institution, respectful of the constitution, laws, agreements, international human rights treaties, and international humanitarian law, law of war. The Army carries out many humanitarian and social activities in our society. But we must not forget that its main mission is to defend the society in case it is violated our security. The Armed Forces of the Philippines is mandated to serve and protect the people and secure the sovereignty of the state and the integrity of its national territory from internal and external threats. The AFP pledges allegiance to the Filipino people, adheres to the principle of supremacy of civilian authority over the military at all times, and vows to uphold and defend the Constitution. Also, the Army represents a factor for the stability of nation, since it strengthens politics. If this institution were to disappear, it could destabilize internal and external politics. Individuals who learn about historical military events gain insights on how centuries-old conflicts relate to today's unfolding events, provides a deeper understanding of the causes of history's key conflicts, helps us learn why they took place, and provides lessons to help prevent them from happening again. In addition, a nation's military may function as a discrete social subculture with dedicated infrastructure such as military housing, schools, utilities, logistics, hospitals, legal services, food production, finance, and banking services. Beyond warfare, the military may be employed in additional sanction and non-sanctioned functions within the state, including internal security threats, population control, the promotion of a political agenda, emergency services, and reconstruction protecting corporate economic interest, ceremonies, and national honor guards. These are the terms and definition when we talk about of military, like camaraderie, chain of command, chieftain. Camaraderie is a spirit of friendly good fellowship. Civilian authority, dato, and the others. Also, the key personalities and their contributions in the Philippines, the Armed Forces of the Philippines. Do you know that there are Filipino celebrities joined the military? Like Dieter Ocampo, Richard Gomez, and the others, Mateo, Vilma, Dingdong, Gerald, Christopher, Beauty, Let us visit their pictures. Like Colleen Perez. She is a celebrity. Arcy Muñoz. Beauty Gonzalez. Dingdong Dantes. Gerald Anderson. JM De Guzman. Herbert Bautista. Ronnie Liang. Rocco Nacino. Manny Pacquiao, of course. Mateo Kedicheli, AJ Falcon, Christopher De Leon also, Dieter Ocampo. These individuals have proven their wholehearted and patriotic love for their home country as they enlisted in the armed forces of the Philippines as reserve officers. How brave, gallant, and dedicated they are as Filipinos. They would certainly inspire more citizens to follow in their footsteps and volunteer to serve the country by enlisting as a military, navy, or air force reserve. There are living heroes, the five Filipino soldiers who won the Medal of Valor. Who are they? And what is Medal of Valor? Medallion ng Kagitingan, the highest military honor awarded for a conspicuous deed of personal bravery or self-sacrifice above and beyond the call of duty that distinguishes the recipient from his comrades. General Noel Buan, retired. Brigadier General Bartolome Vicente Bacaro. General Custodio Parcon, Second Lieutenant Herbert Dilag, and General Cirilito Sobihana, the Chairman of the Joint Chiefs. You know, there are women in the military. In a male-dominated field, women are fiercely breaking the stereotype and leading the Philippine Army towards greatness. One after another, the achievements of women in the Army are surfacing and they prove to be a valuable asset in carrying out the Army's mission. Like in the pictures in the lower right, five female cadets make it to top 10 of PMA Masidlawin class of 2020. It's unbelievable. Being a soldier is not easy. And being a woman in this field leads to many responsibilities not many of us can take. But these Army women showed their excellence in their units and in serving the people and our country. Women rising up to the challenges and dominating not only proved the women's excellence, they also served as an inspiration to other women in the Philippine Army and young women of the new generation that they can lead and do the work just as good as male. For example, Lieutenant Colonel Leia Santiago, dare to dream and do it. She is also a graduate of Philippine Military Academy class of 1997, the class with the first batch with females in PMA history as summa cum laude. She was able to command and supervise a total of 645 fire missions in support of the maneuver units in Sulu Province that contributed to the neutralization of three Abu Sayyaf group members and permitted the voluntary surrender of three rebels. Lieutenant Colonel Leia Santiago, Philippine Army, First Female Infantry Company Commander and First Female Artillery Battalion Commander. Also, Major Sharon Gomez Orbon, a woman known as Babaeng Mandirigma, dominated the 4th Infantry Division as the first company commander in the field artillery to experience real battle in the campaign against the terrorists in Lanao del Sur and del Norte, dubbed as the Babaeng Mandirigma, First Female Battalion Executive Officer. The first female general, Brigadier General Ramona Palabrigago. She holds a Bachelor of Science in Chemistry degree from the Central Philippine University and a Master's degree in Development Management from the Asian Institute of Management. She joined the military service through the Women's Auxiliary Corps shortly after her graduation from college and thereafter was sent by the Army to train at the Women's Royal Australian Army Corps School and was commissioned as Second Lieutenant and called to active duty in January 1982, commanding officer of the Army Aviation Battalion and the first woman to command a flying unit in the armed forces. Kahanga-hanga, di ba? Oh. These women are committed to their duty, causing them to shine even in an environment dominated by men. They are just the first of many. Many more women that will bring honor to the Philippine Army and will lead us to a better nation. They truly serve as an inspiration. Major, General, and Lieutenant Colonel. What is the status of women in U.S. military? Women make up about 16% of the U.S. Armed Forces. The wars in Iraq and Afghanistan have drastically changed the role of women in the military, placing women in the same daily danger as their male counterparts. Women are serving in non-combat positions traditionally held by men, like gunners in convoys, exposing them to potential enemy attacks. Sexual harassment, assault, psychological and emotional effects. Men and women who suffer sexual trauma are more likely to develop emotional and psychological problems. In many cases, suffer from post-traumatic stress disorder, PTSD. What are the best practices observed in military and brotherhood? All men are created equal and then a few become brothers. No one left behind. No man left behind. In line with the military value system is the mantra that every service member knows and understands without questions. Leave no one behind. No soldier, sailor, airman, or marine will be left on the field of battle. This means that with little regard for their own safety, service members will do everything in their power to retrieve the remains of fallen comrades in order to ensure that they are returned to their families for burial befitting an honorably serving military member. Hand salute also the other best practice observed in military. It's a symbol of respect, honor, and integrity. Place of honor. The place of honor is on the right. Accordingly, when a junior walks, rides, or sits with a senior officer, he takes position abreast and to the left of the senior. Place of honor. Rank has its privileges. Senior given the privileges to select first. Yeah. On quarters, for example, obey first. Never offer excuses. Military ranks also. The other use of the word sir. Sir, the word sir is issued in military conversation by the junior officer in addressing a senior and by all soldier in addressing officers. Chain of command, the flow of authority. Absence without official leave, AWOL, shall be punished as a court-martial may direct. Military personnel reject divisive fraternal organization with the AFP. AFP adheres to the principle of democracy, that the government is of the people, by the people, and for the people. The AFP uphold the supremacy of the civilian authority over the military. Follow the chain of command. Areas for improvement: armed forces recruitment, mental health, personnel and families, modernization, I want you to notice this. The available for military service in the Philippines, as of 2021, 46,000 or 46,947,750. That's the available. But fit for military service, 38 million. But the active personnel, take note of that, only 140,000. Active personnel. Out of 46 million, there are only 140,000 Filipinos as of 2020 as an active personnel. And reserve personnel, 360,000. The total reservist is 770,000. Napakaliit, di po ba? Bakit? Kumpara natin dito. Which country has number one army in the world? China is number one. 2.19 million. Sipin mo yung China. India, United States, North Korea, and Russia, over 1 million. Active personnel. Kita ninyo? Ang Pilipinas ang active personnel, 140,000. Samantalang ang China, 2 million. Ay, isipin mo. Active personnel yan. Layo-layo natin. there are contributions development of an individual by the military. Discipline, courtesy, mahalaga yung military courtesy and discipline. Yan. Military courtesy and military discipline. You can read that. Military contributes to individual mental health, social, spiritual, emotional, and physical development. Okay? Camaraderie, spirit of friendly good fellowship, and brotherhood, not in words, but in actions. Professionalism, patriotism, love of the country. My brother to my left and my brother to my right, together we stand, together we fight. That's the brotherhood. That's the camaraderie of the military. He's not heavy. He's not. He's my brother. Oh. Contribution. Factor for the stability of the nation. Effectively combat drug addiction and gangs. Also, during pandemic, vital contributions of the military. During Brigada Escuela also, stress debriefing, like in Marawi Siege, mental symposium camp, military civilian activities, repatriation and evacuation, and others. Take note of this. Oh, Brigada Escuela. Military personnel are very useful. Army families are the most brittle part of the force. They are sacrificing too much, and we can no longer ask them to just make the best of it. Ganda no sinabi niya yan, no? Di ba? Ito yung sakit ng mga sundalo madalas. Post-traumatic stress disorder. Kaya yung depression, anxiety disorder, substance abuse, and others. Yan nakakaawa din eh. Imagine 1 in 5 former or current service members suffer mental problems. Nag-i-install din ang chaplain, tsaka ng combat stress control teams. Mayroon din tinatawag na military family life counseling, military counseling, stress debriefing. To combat depression, anxiety, substance abuse, and other, they installed counselors. Also, this one, another, this one also, and this one also. Survival, evasion, resistance, and escape training. What is the military current status? As of 2011, gay, lesbian, and bisexual servicemen have been allowed to serve openly, and now dependent benefits extended to same-sex spouses. Sa Amerika yan. That's all. Thank you so much.